What is going on YouTube? This is Jim back with another video, and I just got home from the Halo Championship Series Orlando 2018 Open Invitational. This is a three-day event kicking off the Halo Championship Series for 2018. They're going to be bouncing around a few different cities, Orlando, London, Sydney. Ultimately, they're going to end up at the home of the Seattle Seahawks in the Seattle Stadium. I don't know what the name of it is. Where they're going to crown a winner, and the $1 million check goes to the winning team. So this was the first in the, you know, I think there's like four or five stops. There's one in Mexico as well. And I wanted to give my feedback on it because I am a pretty big Halo fan, but I've yet to go to a live championship event. A lot of these take place. DreamHack is a really common one. That's way out in, you know, like Colorado. Sometimes Texas will do one. You don't really see them come this way. So when I heard that they were going to actually come through Orlando, my hometown, like, oh my God, I have to go, right? So immediately bought a ticket, and I went both Friday and Sunday. Saturday, I took the day off, but I did watch at home. And I wanted to get my feedback on it because, you know, a lot of people may wonder what it's like, and there's not really a lot of discussion that I've seen online. I didn't know what to expect, but now that I've been there and I've seen it and I understand it a little bit better, I could maybe give some advice on somebody who's considering going. So first of all, Major League Gaming, MLG, has taken the reins back of Halo, and they are now the ones that are coordinating it. Now, MLG is owned by Activision Blizzard, so they got some deep pockets, so you can expect some pretty high production values in everything that they do, and this was definitely no exception. One thing I think a lot of people don't understand when I tell them that I went to this, talking to some of my friends before I did this video, is it's not like an E3 convention. Yes, it is about a video game, but it's taken very seriously as an eSport, very similar to the way you would go to a basketball game or a professional football game. It's not like there's tons of swag and they're handing out tons of gift cards and goodie bags. You're paying to go watch an event. In this particular case, it's people playing a video game. But you know, you could argue that, you know, it's no different than going to watch people play a sport game. I mean, to me, it is an e-sport, right? So this one was a little bit different though, because it was the Open Invitational. So any team could register to play. I could have registered to play. And what they decided to do was they left some slots open. So they had 12 professional teams, or I'm sorry, 9 professional teams already there for a group A, B, C, and D. But they all had a blank spot. So it was pretty much like 2 United States teams and then 1 international team. Some teams were from Mexico. There were some teams from the United Kingdom. And there were a couple, I think just the one team, Mind Freak, they were from Australia. So you have all these different teams, and then you had a blank spot. And what they did was anybody who broke out of the ranks in the Open Invitational got a walk-on onto the tournament, which was actually a really cool idea because anyone could make it, you know? It's like, so while the first couple days were practice kind of for the pro teams, just putting on kind of exhibition matches, you had these other teams working their way up to enter into the tournament. Well, as you would probably expect, every one of those teams was thoroughly trashed and trounced and pretty much swept. So Slayer, like, is first to 50 kills, and like it would be like 50 to like 14, 50 to 16. You were doing Capture the Flag, they'd lose 3-0 in like 4 or 5 minutes. It was interesting to watch. I wouldn't necessarily say they were thrown to the wolves. I mean, a lot of these amateur teams did have professional players on them who didn't land on an established team. So there were a lot of names floating around that I heard. Commonly, for example, who was a big member last year of Team Envious, who left to go play Call of Duty. He actually was on a pro team, and they did pretty well. So I wouldn't say it's just like nobodies. And they all pretty much had like professional jerseys made, and they seemed like they were established or trying to get established. So that part was cool, but totally thrown to the wolves. So the first 2 days were weeding out both the amateur teams that rose up the rank, and then the second day was all the international teams getting weeded out. And just as you expected, the major named United States teams that are always in the championships were exactly the ones that made it to the championship rounds. How the tournament was laid out was the way the layout of the floor plan was. Everything that you would watch on Twitch stream was simulcast up in the air, and then you were just sitting there watching the players live. They had two rows of exhibition consoles on each side. That's where all the like open bracket worked their way up. And then they had three featured stages up in the front, which were smaller stages. They called them red, blue, and green stages. And that's where, if you watch the Bravo stream, which was like games that were broadcast but not commentated on, that's where those games were being played. So pretty much Halo, as far as you could see in any direction, always a game going on, always something happening. But that's really all there was to it. I mean, you were there to watch Halo, and that's exactly what I did. So it didn't surprise me that there wasn't some crazy giveaway, or that, you know, everyone got free controllers or play with the pros or any of that stuff. I mean, people were there to do a job, and you kind of got to watch, and they were cool about it. I pretty much met just about every pro and every announcer, Wonder Boy, Golden Boy, Elamite, Bravo, Walshy, Strongside. They were all there. Onset, got to meet all those guys, super cool dudes. Got to meet all the pros from every team, Optic Gaming and Team Envious and Reciprocity and Infused and just everybody. So it was cool. Just, you know, if you're a fan of that, it's neat to see the players and just kind of walk around and just be people, because if you're like me, you kind of idolize some of these guys because of how amazing they are in Halo. But, you know, you go to the bathroom and there's like, you know, sniped on taking a leak like two stalls over you. It's like, oh, he's just a dude like the rest of us. Or you see him in line getting a pizza or a Coke or something. So it was fun. I really did enjoy it. So if you're a fan of the game, if they're doing any of these tournaments, and it's an MLG run, they don't just do Halo. They do Call of Duty. I believe they've now re-signed with Gears of War, but I'm not entirely sure. But if you're a fan of any of these games, I really encourage you guys to go check it out and to go, participate. They do a lot of times have like these open tournaments where you can go play if you wanted to. But if nothing else, just go sit and watch for a while. That live atmosphere, especially in the finals game with Splice versus Optic Gaming, I mean, people were standing up cheering and screaming and hooting and hollering. Like, you know, Frosty got that sniper rifle, I think, in the third match, and he just went off and took out three dudes, like, triple headshot. Like, everybody, like, the place went nuts. Like, the ceiling just blew off the building. And that positive energy of everybody screaming and cheering and having fun was just really, really, really cool to be a part of. My wife did go with me on the last day, and after the match was over, she turned to me and she's like, I have goosebumps. I'm like, I do too. Like, and I'm not even a Splice Gaming fan. I'm a Reciprocity fan. They got knocked out. They're in fourth place. So I was watching a final between Optic Gaming and Splice, two teams that I'm not huge fans of, but here I am just cheering for them because these guys are just playing it like next level Halo. So the only criticism I would give about it, though, if any, was that being an MLG sanctioned event, they had a merchandise table, and I was pretty excited for that because I'm like, oh, cool, I'm going to get some merch. I did manage to snag a shirt for me, but unfortunately I couldn't get one for my wife because they didn't really have a lot of stock. So all the pro teams that were there, like all the ones I just mentioned, none of them had booths set up to sell their stuff. Now, that might have been on the pro team's fault. I'm not entirely sure, but like, you would think, like, you know, Optic Gaming would have like their hats or something for sale where you can get it and wear their gear. But no, they didn't. They had the MLG logo everywhere. So I got my wife an MLG shirt, and I got the official Halo Orlando shirt. But they didn't have one in her size, which was really kind of weird. Their merchandise sold out really, really quickly. And other than water bottles and lanyards and stuff, they didn't have a whole lot. And even on Sunday, the last day when we went there, the merchandise table was largely picked over. And I'm kind of surprised that they didn't do a better job, because you have your core audience there. I mean, I am paying $30 to watch people play games. It makes pretty good sense to me that I'm going to invest a little bit and get some swag to take home. But other than that, I can't complain too much. I thought it was run very, very well. I had a really good time there. And if they do come back to Orlando, I'm totally going to get a ticket and go again. So there you guys have it. My thoughts on the Orlando Open, the MLG run, Halo tournament. I'll probably do more videos on this since they are really winding up the 2018 season. I might do recap videos of the action because it's really hard to find a central site for news. And I thought, since I watch so much, I've kind of picked up on this stuff, but we'll see how things go. But as always, I want to thank you guys so much for watching. Get out there and play the best game ever, which is Halo 5. And until next time, I will see you guys on the other side.